Hello, this is Riptide Hosting, here to show you the steps to set up remote desktop access to your home computer. This is a free process, although quite a few steps are required to get through your firewall, cable modem, or DSL modem. Pause if you'd like to read over these. We're going to get right into it. The first step, you need to set your laptop or home computer to allow a remote desktop connection. This is Windows 10. You will right-click on the Windows icon, scroll up and select System. Now, this window appears, and on the left-hand side, select Remote Settings. It should be your second option. When this window opens, select the last tab, which is Remote. Here, you can look at the second section called Remote Desktop and select the second option, Allow Remote Connections to this Computer. If you're running an older version of Remote Desktop on computers that you'd like to use to access your home computer, you may need to uncheck the checkbox which says allow connections only from computers running Remote Desktop with network level authentication. Once you've done that, you need to log into your modem, firewall, or other device which your computer is connected to for internet access. Your login information is usually found on the actual modem itself. Usually the address is 192.168.0.1. You log in via a web browser. Once you log in this case, we need to select Advanced Setup. Once you've clicked Advanced Setup, you're looking for port forwarding. In this case, for DSL router, down on the bottom left under the Security tab, you will see Port Forwarding. When you click that, this page will open up. At this point, you need the internal IP of your computer. To get the internal IP of your computer, you can open the command window. To do this, click on the Windows icon in the bottom left-hand corner once again and type in the letters CMD. Your window should now look like this. Hit your Enter button. This window will appear, and before you see all the information here, at the very top, you need to type in ipconfig. It's on the third line after C:users. ipconfig, hit enter. At this point, you need the information down there listed next to wireless LAN adapter Wi-Fi, in this case, because we are connected via the Wi-Fi network. We're going to use the IPv4 address for the next screen. If you need more information to make sure your home computer always gets the same internal IP, you may need to run the command ipconfig/all, which we will show you here, which will return quite a bit more information, including the MAC address. Once you get that information, come back to the window for your modem or firewall. In our case, we could select in the dropdown our computer that matched the IP that we found. Next, you need to enter the port 3389 for both the starting port and ending port. This is the default port for remote desktop services, also known as terminal services, on older computers. Under protocol, make sure you select TCP and UDP, which is sometimes considered both. Below that, if you're going to allow access from any IP on the internet, you can leave all IP addresses selected. If you know you're always logging in from, let's say, a work computer, you could put that IP in define IP address. To find that public IP of your work computer would be the same when you're at work, as we will show you here. Click Apply once you have this information in. Now, you should be able to log in from outside of your home network. To find your IP address that you would use to log into your home computer you just set up, go to Bing or Google and type in, "What's my IP address?" It will show your IP address right there. Also, a test to do if this does not work for you is to also try to remote desktop in from your internal address, which we found, in this case, was 192.168.0.3. This is often a good test to try after you've made those first settings to allow remote desktop connections to your computer. This also comes in handy if you have two computers at home and you would like to copy files back and forth or run a program on the other computer. The limitation with setting up your home computer for remote desktop access or a computer at your office is that only one user can log in at a time. Riptide Hosting offers remote desktop hosting for multiple users to one computer. This allows you to run any Windows program from any device that has internet access with a remote desktop connection app installed. On our website, you can get pricing online. Click on remote desktop hosting, and depending on how many users you have or the resources you need, you may select a virtual or a dedicated server. In this case, we will show you the virtual server pricing page. You can select the number of CPUs, RAM, or disk space. Once this total comes to about $200 a month for the server, you can also get a dedicated server with more power. Once you've selected the server itself, select the operating system you would like to use, the number of users, and any software you would like. You may also give us a call or send us an email with any questions. This pricing calculator will give you a price for most of the options that people would like.